My name is Tom Clemente. I'm the Eugene W. Price Professor of Biotechnology. I'm an agricultural biotechnologist, and I've been doing this for 30 years. Been at UNL for 20 years. What I like about my job is I do work with a diverse group of researchers and then always interacting with the students, which makes working at a land-grant university the best thing than working in the private sector.
Hi, my name is Shirley Sato. I'm the lab manager in the Plant Transformation Core facility located in the Beetle Center at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. I've been with the university for about 18 years. As a lab manager, my duties are varied and differ from day to day. I do whatever I can to ensure that the researchers in my lab have the supplies and whatever help they need to conduct their research in a very efficient manner. So I'm ordering supplies, replenishing stocks, and I actually help out with the research itself. I sit down and do tissue culture and molecular biology to help. I don't have a specific project that I work on, but I help in all the projects.
People need to know, regardless of the age, of the tools of biotechnology and how they're used for agriculture in general, is that it's merely a spoke in the wheel to help maintain a plentiful and safe food supply. For any farmer's harvest, the yield, if you will, there's two components. You have the genetic component, and then you have the agronomic inputs. This tools of biotechnology is this one aspect to complement the way we improve the genetics. So that's all it is. There's no magic bullet about it. It's just a simple little spoke in the wheel to maintain a plentiful and safe food supply.
In our lab, we are constantly introducing new genes into plants. And we do this through a process called agro-mediated transformation. And it's a very natural process. What we do is we use a bacteria that is found in the soil and has the ability to transfer a piece of its DNA into a plant cell. In nature, it causes a gall in a tree, crown gall. But what scientists have discovered that we can manipulate that little piece of DNA that gets put into the plant cell and put our own genes of interest in, and that way we can modify the plant.
Without this ability to add genetic variation to any species, be it a crop or an animal, you can't improve upon it. If you can't maintain the genetic variation, then you're at that the gap, if you will, you're at the ceiling of the output, whether it's a yield or nutritional. So you need a constant supply of genetic variation to slowly improve. You heard of inbreeding. If you have too much inbreeding, whether it's a human population or a plant population, you're stagnant in further evolution. So this is merely that tool to maintain, piece by piece, additional genetic variation. So we need this in order to maintain this plentiful and safe food supply. With one of the greatest assets the United States of America possesses is its ability to produce its food. There's not many countries in the world that can do this. This is just one little tool to help us maintain that. The public perception of this biotechnology is usually a negative. So what we have to do now is educate, get to the grade schools and junior high schools and start educating at that level about biology, about agriculture, and why we're doing what we're doing. And we can hopefully just say these older generations that have this misunderstanding of what this technology is and is not will slowly fade away. We're helping all sides of where agriculture does, the farmer to the product to the supermarket. There are so-called input traits for genetic variation. Those benefit the farmers. That's where you get for the weed control management, pest control management, or nutritional improvement. Then you have the output component where you're going to help the general consumer for the nutritional aspects or for the shelf life and potential of food products.
I feel very passionate about my research in that I think in some small way I may have an impact on helping to feed the world, because we know that the population is growing immensely and quickly, and we need to generate more food more effectively and efficiently.
Stay in school, go to college, and never stop learning. That's the piece of advice I have for the next generation.